stopping when they reached the street corner. They huddled together and stared at their surroundings. Teams of horses were pulling wagons up the hill, away from the mine, and an enormous chimney was belching black smoke into the sky. Down the hill, several more of the massive chimneys were also pouring out smoke. "What's happening?" Natalie asked in a shaky voice. "I don't understand what's happening." "We're trying to figure that out," her mother said. She wanted to reassure her daughter, but she was concentrating on her reading, trying not to hyperventilate. Alex whispered to himself, "Wake up, wake up," while his father simply stood there looking dazed. Bill checked his watch and looked carefully in every direction. "Would you like to sit down?" Alex asked his mother. "You look a little wobbly." "Maybe you could sit on one of those big rocks by the corner," said his father. Concern for his wife seemed to have snapped him out of his daze. "You do look a little pale." Taking the suggestion, she moved closer to the rocks and sat down on one of them. She continued taking slow, deep breaths. "If you think you might faint, you should put your head between your knees," Alex said authoritatively. He had recently completed most of the requirements for his Boy Scout First Aid Merit Badge. The only requirement left was demonstrate competency performing CPR. He'd already made one attempt to pass the CPR test, but it didn't go very well. He was quite sure, though, about how to treat lightheadedness. His mother looked up at him with a little smile. "Thanks for the reminder, but I don't think I'm going to faint." "How did they change everything so fast?" Benjamin asked. "I don't know," his father replied. He continued to take in his surrounding. "It's almost like..." His voice trailed off. Natalie raised her head, and they all watched as a wagon pulled by four horses went slowly up the hill in front of them. The horses strained against a heavy load of rocks and dirt in the bed of the wagon, and with every step they took a new little puff of dust from the road, joined the cloud around their hooves. After the wagon passed, Alex asked, "Wasn't this road paved before we went into the mine?" "I'm pretty sure it was," Natalie said, feeling disoriented and queasy. "Do you think?" Alex said, faltering. "I keep expecting to wake up," said his father. "Me too," said Alex. Bill cleared his throat. "I'm going to go up the hill and take a quick look around. Maybe I can find out what happened. If the rest of you want to stay here and wait for me, I'll be back in just a few minutes." After everyone agreed they would wait while he checked things out, Bill turned and walked briskly up the hill. The tailors watched him until he went around the corner and disappeared from sight. Natalie and Alex looked at each other with similar expressions of disbelief on their faces. Neither one of them could make sense of what was happening. Unconcerned by the situation, Benjamin watched a line of ants marching to and from their anthill. It seemed like such an ordinary thing that the rest of the family watched them for a while, too. Eventually, Alex looked away. "Is anyone else hungry?" he asked. "You're hungry?" his mother asked him. She was incredulous. "How can you be hungry?" "Well, actually, I'm not sure," Alex said. "I might throw up instead."
Stop there for now.